Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Today's Winthrop. And today is, we're celebrating something very special today. This is the third annual Veterans Meet and Greet, and I'm here starting off the whole show with my host, Roger. Roger, what's up?
I'm one more time. I'm so happy to host this show again over here, this dinner. I hope everybody show up. We so proud to give something back for our veterans. They support our business and we are support them. So we so happy to be here again this year for the 30th annual.
And I want to mention, which I should have done at the beginning of the show, we are at the Center Cafe, right down the Winthrop Center. And it's not even 6 o'clock yet, and the place is full. What are you going to do?
Yes. You know, it's like we have this place for everybody. We have room for everyone. We have food already made, you know. So.
Well, what's on today's menu?
Meatloaf with vegetable, white rice, and a broccoli chicken ziti.
And I noticed the vegetables, and I'm into cooking, so the vegetables had a red, like a covering on it. What is that?
Yeah, we have a grilled vegetable, a seasoning with sazon and a vegetable seasoning. Cook on a grill and olive oil, so it's real tasty.
And who likes sazon better than me?
Everyone like this vegetable. Whatever they come over here, they try the first time, they fell in love for the vegetable.
And if you've ever been down here, and I know we've done the show before, Roger has a wall just set up for veterans. And if you have a veteran that might have passed, or and I'm sure we can find space up there for people to come down and see it. We would find a space for them, wouldn't we?
Of course. So I have a lot of room on my wall. I can't put how many veterans come ask me. It's my pleasure to put everyone on. Everybody come over here, ask me, doesn't matter what war, doesn't matter how the age, I get everyone. I want everybody.
You know, Roger, I'm gonna let you go back this time, because normally I keep you here for a long time, but we got you here early at night and go back, and he's been here all day. So this guy and his crew have been here from what, 5 this morning?
4:30 in the morning.
4:30 in the morning. It's now 6 at night, and it hasn't even started yet. Yeah. So, Roger, on behalf of people from Winthrop, every veteran, which I'm not, but I want to thank you very much.
You're welcome. I hope see everyone next year again. We're never going to stop over here. We're going to make it just a tradition every year for Winthrop.
You keep serving this good food. They're not going to leave.
Thank you, John. Thank you, everyone, for show up, everyone to come. And who don't have a chance to come this year, I hope see you next year. God bless everybody.
And he really means that. Great man.
Thank you.
It is my deep pleasure to introduce the next person, which everybody knows anyways, Rose Mazzichelli.
How we doing?
I always mess up that name, but, you know, after the first 20 letters, you know.
Yes, I understand.
Now, Rose is the organizer of this event, the third annual meet and greet. Rose, I mean, every year it gets busier and busier. It's not even 6 o'clock yet, and we're starting to fill up.
I know. Isn't that a great thing?
Now, I see you got a table set up over there. What is that now?
My table, I just have some giveaways for the guys and gals, because we do have females. Just some flags that I make, the people who turn flags into me. I save the star. I got one when I was at the Parvia school at another veterans event, and I loved it. So that's what I do before we burn our flags. And Dudley Farquhar donated a whole box of pens for me. So
which I stole one already.
That's okay. That's what they're there for. So, and I have my business card for anybody who still needs to get hold of me to see what benefits they deserve or entitled to. They can pick up my card and call me up and make an appointment.
Now, Rose is the veterans agent in Winthrop. And I want to point out one thing that I remember going to the, it was near the town hall. You were giving out food?
Food. We run a veterans and family of veterans monthly food bank. And we tied in with the Greater Boston Food Bank of Boston, but we pick up our food in Revere at the American Legion there. And every month, usually the first Wednesday of the month, we pick up about 20 to 30 pounds of food per person, per family. And then I have food coming in from all sorts of people who come to my office and donate food or gift cards. I'm getting turkeys for Thanksgiving, and these are for our lower income veterans and families, those who may need some help, those who are moving and maybe they have an empty cupboard and they just need something in there to just keep their belly warm.
I walked into that room and there was more food than the Winthrop marketplace. It was, I mean, I couldn't believe how many bags of food. How many bags do you give out?
We give out between 2 and 3 bags of food per family. Bigger families get more, of course. And we also had the New England Center for Homeless Vets made tons of donations with toiletries, toothbrushes, deodorant, shampoo. And so we give that out. We have socks, we have underwear, we have belts. So people can get their food and grab some toiletries. We service about 45 to 50 families.
Now, and I know we have to let you go because I know you're chomping at the bit. You have so much to do to kick this off. But if a veteran wants to get in touch with you, what is the best way? Phone number, email, what's the best way?
They can call me at Town Hall at 617-846-3065. I'm in the basement of Town Hall. More and more people are saying that you're never in your office because I'm outreaching. Just last Friday, I had to go see 2 veterans, one at the Arbors and one at the Winthrop Housing. So I am outreaching. If a vet can't get to me, I have no problem going to them with all of the paperwork and we'll take care of business.
Tenacious and very pretty, our best looking veterans agent in years, and no offense to Larry Holmes, I always say that, but Rose, you do a great job. Everybody I talk to, I have coffee with the veterans in the morning, all say that you're there for them, and on behalf of those veterans and every veteran that you help, thank you very much.
Thank you, because I am proud to serve all of them.
And thank you for serving also, because she is a veteran.
21 years, U.S. Army. Woo, woo.
Imagine her with the gun chasing you down. I feel bad for her husband.
That's okay. He's used to it. Thanks, John.
Thanks, Rose.
Thank you.
Go ahead, Rose. I'm sorry.
That's okay.
All right, listen up.
Welcome, everyone. This is our 3rd annual Dining In for Veterans Day. Thank you all. This is put on sponsored by the American Legion, Post 146 in Winthrop, as well as Rich Honan's fund that he gets from people who sent him like thousands and thousands of dollars. And I just want to welcome my fellow veterans, family members, invited guests. This one is extremely special because we are paying tribute to someone we just lost. So, Bud Dacey, who is near and dear in our heart. If you all can see on the window over there, Bud Dacey's shirt that Kathy came to the office and brought to me. I felt so honored that she chose me to give his shirt to. So he was great. He was so humbled and honored that we asked him to be our Grand Marshal in our Memorial Day parade, which was phenomenal this year. So thanks to the hard work of the American Legion and everyone else who participated. So tomorrow, just a heads up, if it's raining at 10 o'clock, we're moving into the Methodist Church. Veterans Day ceremonies are never canceled. Okay, we will always have a Veterans Day ceremony, whether it be on town, in town property, in town lawn, or the Methodist Church. They opened it up, but we're not gonna make that decision until 10 o'clock tomorrow morning because I put great pressure on Reverend May to take care of that for us. So, just kidding, no. No guns, I'm not allowed to have any guns. Bob Dion said, no, I'm not allowed any guns. So, and my husband took them away a long time ago, so it doesn't matter. So I have 2 special people who I've invited, and they've become great friends of ours, and that's MJ Majors, Mary Jo Majors, who spent a lot of time with Bud. And Kathy Dacey, I asked to come, Bud Dacey's daughter. So I have, Kathy is going to come up and make a presentation. Hold it. Make it easier for you.
Okay. Hi, I'm Kathy. I'm Bud Dacey's daughter. I am so honored to be here tonight because Dad loved coming here. So I feel his presence, and I hope you do too. I have a special gift that I'd like to give to the American Legions. This is taken back in 2001 at the Town Hall on Veterans Day. And
Richie Gay, the commander, would you please post?
And I'd like to present it to them.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
That was from 2001.
One.
Wow, what a crew, huh? Very nice, isn't it? Yeah. Huh? Very good. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
This will hang at the American Legion Hall. And for those who didn't know, my son Paul did his Eagle project there, restored a couple of rooms. So we're going to have an open house probably right after Christmas so that you all can come down and see the Legion, maybe become a member. We have a lot of fun. We do a lot of great things. And now the second?
I also have a present for the captain.
MJ?
MJ. And my dad, it will be 2 years this coming May that he went on the honor flight, and we found out that MJ was part of the honor flight, but she wasn't there the time that my dad went. So I would like to give her this.
Oh, thank you so much. Look at that. And I know it'll fit, right?
Hey.
Hey. Thank you, sweetie. That's great. That's great.
Sorry. I hope I hope everybody enjoys tonight, and I know I am, and have a great Veterans Day tomorrow, and I'd just like to thank you all for what you've done for our country, and I know how much my dad loved our country, and I love you all too. Thank you.
Reverend May, would you do the honors, please?
Would you all join me as we give thanks for this night? Merciful God, we gather here tonight as loved ones, as friends, in fellowship time to give thanks right now for the many blessings that you've given us, the very blessing of life itself. We ask, Lord, that you would bless the food that is being prepared for us tonight. Lord, we would ask that you would bless those hands that are preparing it. We give this night to you, and we give you thanks for all that you've done. In your precious and glorious name we pray. Amen.
Thank you. And now, we'd just like to say a quick thank you to Roger for coming through once again, providing us the food and his service and his place that most of you love and hang out here all day long. And we are truly grateful because what he has done for the community, his wall of heroes, I mean, that everyone comes in and just marvels at. So just a big round of applause for Roger.
Thank you. Thank you.
And now I want to get this out of the way right at the beginning. Happy birthday to the Marine Corps. Go Army.
Paul Flynn, Navy, 44 to 47.
Bob McGeorge, 65 to 69.
Bill McGeorge, U.S. Marine Corps, 1958-1962.
Oh, wow. Hello.
What's your name, sir?
Al Campidelli, United States Army.
Years?
Glad to be here. 3 years.
No, what years?
Oh, 56, 50, 55, 6, and 7.
Thank God there was no war that year.
U.S. Army, 79 to 2000, Military Police Corps.
Jim Corkum, U.S. Navy Intelligence, 54 to 58. Served in the Aleutian Islands.
Tony Brogna, U.S. Marine Corps, dropped Charis Island, North Carolina, and Cherry Point. 1955.
Lorraine Farmer, United States Marine Corps,
1952 to 53.
Phil Demento, United States Submarine Force, 1956 to 59.
Joe Quigley, U.S. Army.
Years?
Three.
Dudley Farquhar, U.S. Army, 68 to 70, and then 82 to 86 reserves.
My name is Bob Dion, Branch of Service, United States Marine Corps, and happy birthday to all Marines. Time of service, 1965 to 1972.
And his wife's serving time right now. Okay, wait, just ask for your name and the years. Well, you just got out, so. So just say your name and ask. No.
Ready? I'm Mary Jo Majors. I'm a retired Navy Nurse Corps captain, and I served from December 1968 to March 2011.
And this is a special guest, as you heard earlier today. This is Buddy's daughter, and Kathy. And Kathy, tell us about your dad.
My dad was in the war, in World War II. He was in the Navy. He was a gunner's mate. And he was on LST 344. And my dad was at D-Day when he was 19 years old. And about 8 years ago, with a few friends and my uncle, Bob Oliver, went back to Normandy. And I said, Dad, I said, what was the first thing you did when you were on the beach? He says, I took my shoes off and socks so I could walk in the water. And he was just so thrilled to be there and walking around and looking. But the cemetery touched his heart of all the soldiers that were there and all the white flags, I mean, crosses that, you know, nobody claimed. But my dad also did a project for all the schools. It was called D-Day in a Box, and it explained everything about World War II being over there in D-Day. He went to schools, he went to restaurants. Anybody that wanted to see it, my dad did it. And they would even pick him up. He even did Skype to Pennsylvania because his boss's grandson wanted to have him be introduced to their class in Pennsylvania, and he had such a great time doing it. Dad just enjoyed life so much, and he did a lot of things, and I know he's with us because he's happy that I'm here with you all because he loved being here. Thank you.
I have to tell you one story about your dad. You gotta understand, we had coffee with him 3-4 times a week. He was down there just about every day.
Yes.
And I remember when he turned 89, he comes down and he goes, you know, John, I got to give up downhill skiing.
That's right.
And then when he turned 90, he says, for like 2 or 3 days, he said he gave up golf, but he really didn't.
No, we didn't. he was just getting upset that his golfing wasn't as good as it used to be, and his scores weren't good.
It was still better than mine. And then he'd go, oh, wait a minute, and you look at his watch, I got to get to work.
Yeah.
But he'll be well missed.
Oh, he's missed every day, and this is home to him, and I'm glad I'm here tonight.
Made it special.
Thank you.
Mario Conti, Navy. I was aboard the SS Leyte, 1952 to 1956.
Bob Sloan, U.S. Navy. Stay off of my ships because you're born.
That's why I can't take a fishing because I'll probably hit a torpedo. Okay, now we have the last table. The table I sort of, and if you look on it, the table I try to stay away from. And what do? I start off with Bill. Bill, take it away.
All right.
Yeah, take it away.
Army. 1967 to 1970. Stationed in Fort Lewis, Washington. Aviation.
Mike Hammerman, United States Coast Guard, 1981, thank you, to 1985.
Rich Duval, Air Force, 62, 66.
Hey, that's the year I was born.
Wow. General, General.
General, the General. Richard Gay, U.S. Army, 1971-72.
Andrew Guilfoyle, 2005 to present, U.S. Army Reserves, currently stationed out of Fort Devens.
Wow, Andrew.
Paul Levy, U.S. Navy, 1971 to 1975.
Amendola, Fred. Air Force.
Air Force. Delbrook Bins.
We needed that one.
George Bolster, U.S. Marine Corps.
I am here with the man, the legend, the myth, Richard Gay, commander of the Winthrop American Legion Post number 146?
146, yes, that's true. Thank you, John, thank you.
No, all kidding aside, I mean, you guys put this together. You financed the whole thing along with Rich's thing, and, you know, I mean, that's a really good thing.
Right, right. No, you know, Rose does a lot, Jimmy Williams, and, of course, Roger is in charge of most of the stuff. You know, we just supply the money as all that we can, but it's basically put on by them. It really is. No, it's a great time. It's chaos out there, isn't it?
It's great. You said, how much food did you eat?
I don't, you know, I had two servings. I always have to have them. Even if I'm not hungry, I'll eat two, really.
No, I have to.
Now I can feel it, actually. I really can.
I want to also say, on behalf of the Winthrop residents, we got you here, the job you guys did on the Memorial Day Parade was just incredible.
Yeah, no, that was a lot of fun, actually. Like I said it before, but we have a great group of guys. We all got together. We started early. We kept with it. The thing just gelled right in, and it just took off, and it was simple is what it really was. With all the cooperation and stuff that we got.
Well, it sort of fell into place, but it's a lot of work.
Everybody in the town fell in with it. They wanted to be part of it, and the whole thing just went right together.
Now, tonight's the same thing.
Happy with everybody with that. Yeah, tonight's the same thing, actually, yeah.
And you have all these veterans together. It's a meet and greet, and they do just that. They sit down, they talk to each other. And I heard one guy, he looked forward to this day, because that's when he gets to see him.
And that's true, too. Yeah, no, everybody just getting together, and everybody knows one another in this town and everything. It really is not a great town to be involved with stuff like this. And that's one of the things I'm trying to emphasize, to get more people to join the American Legion, join all these organizations. If you're a veteran, just come and join. We have nothing but fun. You know, there's no baloney that goes on with this Legion either. Really,
and you do a lot of work.
Yeah, we do a lot of work, but we do have a lot of fun, and everybody's happy, I think, myself.
No, no, without question.
Yeah, yeah.
And no, I want to say,
great group of guys, it really is.
I want to say, on behalf of, first of all, thank you all, right, everybody here, sure, for your service. It's important for us to so you guys know that.
Yeah.
And it's a great that you get all these guys together. And I'm looking forward to next year, kid.
Yeah, no, and you have a big help too, John. We're looking forward to dealing with you again.
I must owe him money.
As always. No, thank you. Thanks again.
No, thank you, Rich.
Thank you. We'll be right back.